Tomorrow, a special interview with Barry Manilow.
And some advice on parenting.
Tomorrow at 9.
Remember how your parents cared for you? Now they need your care.
A strange murder.
Look at her throat.
A persistent reporter, Darren McGavin.
This nut thinks he is a vampire.
An editor who doesn't believe it.
I expect you to report, not to come up with fairy tales.
One man knows the truth.
I know that the only way you're going to get him is if you proceed under the assumption that he's a real live vampire. Oh.
Bullets won't stop the Night Stalker. Today, Darren McGavin, Carol Lynley, and Simon Oakland star in The Night Stalker, the 3:30 movie on Channel 7, next.
No evidence of dependent lividity either.
Peel back the chest flap, please. This should do it.
It's incredible.
Begin the gross work on internal organs. I'm going to phone the district attorney. And don't talk about this to anyone.
I came into it 2 days later, called back 97 miles from the first vacation I had had in 2.5 years because the story is so big no one else can handle it, according to our lovable managing editor. Rumor has it that the day Anthony Albert Vincenzo was born, his father left town. The story may be apocryphal, but I believe it. The only point I wonder about is why his mother didn't leave, too.
Good morning, slaves. We are not amused.
Kolchak, you are ordered.
A two-day-old, third-rate murderer.
You are ordered.
From vacation. What about them?
They have other assignments.
You're beautiful when you're angry.
Out.
Out.
First stop, county general to see one of my most reliable spies. At least he used to be reliable.
Hello, Carl. Oh, I thought you were disbarred from Mal Francis.
I thought we were rid of you for 2 weeks.
Yeah, so did I. Well, about this, Cheryl Hughes thing. Why does it say officially undetermined under cause of death?
Why don't you ask the coroner?
Oh, thanks.
Come on, you're my spy here. Listen, haven't I kept quiet about all those illegal operations you've been performing in closets?
Come on, tell me true
now, John. Was there anything unusual about the autopsy?
No, all I know is she lost a lot of blood.
Yeah, some spy.
I'm just a poor, hard-working doctor that occasionally takes pity on an aging reporter. Dr.
Yeah,
O'Brien, any message
like a Pulitzer Prize story to me.
Second stop, the Gold Dust Saloon, and a chat with Gail Foster, one of Cheryl Hughes' fellow workers, and a rather close friend of mine.
Poor Cheryl. I feel just terrible about it, Carl.
Well, honey, if you don't want to talk about it, you don't have to.
No. No, I want to help if I can.
You said that she never had any boyfriend.
No, none that I ever heard of. She dated once in a while, but never the same man twice. I don't think she likes men.
Yeah?
Yeah. She even took karate lessons in case one got fresh with her.
You mean that she knew karate?
Yeah. Brown belt. Oh, I see him. I've got to go. Bye-bye.
In any town the size of Las Vegas, the murder of one young woman hardly causes a ripple. But then the ripple started. Thursday, May 20th, 7:02 a.m.
Over there. I didn't go down. I couldn't.
Okay, okay. Don, take your statement.
Oh,
What took you so long, Kolchak?
I got a flat tire.
Not a footprint inside.
Is that physically possible?
If it happened, it's possible.
Well, it sure looks like it happened.
Well, come on.
Bonnie Reynolds, 27, divorced. Cocktail waitress at the Harem Room Casino.
Look at her throat.
She must have lost an awful lot of blood.
Carol Hughes lost a lot of blood, too.
You read that in the newspapers, did you?
No, I didn't read that in the newspapers.
This girl lost a lot of blood, Sheriff. But she didn't lose it here.
Anything?
We found a purse. There's signs of a struggle up here.
Nothing in between. Only our footprints.
What'd he do, throw her?
Who said Bonnie Reynolds was thrown 22 feet into that car? The coroner? I haven't heard about it. Who said this new killing is connected with the Cheryl Hughes murder? The police? Not to me, they haven't. Who said Cheryl Hughes died of massive blood loss? The coroner again? No, he hasn't even sent in his report yet. And who, may I ask, said that a super powerful madman is running loose in Las Vegas? You hearing voices, Kolchak?
I did not make up the
fact. Oh, I know your boy. Big-time reporter like you, condemned to the sticks with those journalistic rules.
I did not make
up. I know you'd like a big, fat byline on a big, fat story so you can pay your way back to a big, fat city job.
I did not.
I expect you to report, not to come up with fairy tales. Now, Kolchak, quit bugging the PD. If something turns up, they'll let us know. Meanwhile, use your head and lay off. Whatever they're up to, they don't want any help from amateur bloodhounds like you.
SOS? Who doesn't? Americans buy more than 2 million SOS pads every day. And with good reason, because nothing cleans baked on, burnt on, splattered on messes faster or easier than a super grease-cutting SOS soap pad. SOS. We deserve every dirty pan we get.
Government regulations say we can make our Hebrew National beef hot dogs from frozen beef. We don't. The government says we can use artificial coloring. We don't. They say we can add meat byproducts. We don't. They say we can add non-meat fillers. We can't. We're kosher and have to answer to an even higher authority.
The Spees Farm, a place where friends and neighbors came to pluck ripe apples from the branch. And a wooden wheel turned those crisp, fresh apples to crisp, golden juice. Spees Farm apple juice. Nothing added to it. Nothing artificial about it.
Introducing Spees Farm apple juice. It isn't made, it's grown.
Share your day. Reach out and touch someone.
Super, see you in San Diego then.
Reach out and touch someone far away. Give them a call.
If McCurdy had suggested that the murders were committed by a giant butterfly, he couldn't have made more sparks.
Now, what do you mean, human? Are you suggesting that each of these women was bitten in the throat by a man?
At present, the evidence points that way. However, I couldn't and wouldn't hazard a guess as to the motivation. I can only be sure they each died from shock induced by massive loss of blood.
Dr. McCurdy, is it possible that he killed these women by biting them in the throat for the express purpose of drinking their blood?
Kolchak, now you're here by the mutual suffrage of us all.
Sufferance.
What?
It's sufferance, Sheriff.
Well, whatever it is, just shut up.
I'll answer that. There have been cases of people who, through some mental derangement, have come to believe they were vampires. In Germany in the 1920s, there was one fellow who did use his teeth to rip out his victim's
throat. Now, we are not going to jump to any conclusions about who or what killed these women.
It is possible, you know, to type a person's blood from his saliva. If I were you, gentlemen, I'd look for a very anemic fellow, possibly with some rare blood disease.
Well, I don't care what kind of a nut killed these women. But I'll tell you this, he's out there, and I bet he's high on pot or the hard stuff, and he's going to kill again unless he's stopped. Masterson, what have your people got on this Parkway blood theft?
Well, the latest is the nurse said she saw something funny out there last night, or early this morning. Seems that a tall, skinny guy dressed as an orderly was nosing around the refrigerated storage area. It's where they keep the blood in the plasma. She didn't think much of it then, but later when she spoke about the guy to the floor super, she was told that there was no such tall, skinny guy on duty there. Description as follows. White male adult. 6'2" to 6'4". Thin. About 175 pounds of pale complexion. Dark hair.
So we start looking for a man, local resident, or worse yet, some outsider who may not even still be in the area. We check the airport, the bus terminal, railroad station, blockade the highways, and if we're lucky, we'll get him. If he's stupid enough to still be hanging around after three crimes. Now, you got any other suggestions?
Just do it. All right, let's break this up.
Thank you, Dr. Thank you, Doctor.
Mr. Payne. I shouldn't be too inclined to reject Mr. Kolchak's theory out of hand if I were you. It is at best highly speculative, but not altogether unwarranted.
Kolchak. You can throw away that cassette. Now, this vampire stuff is to stay right in this room. Until we have the assailant in custody, we say nothing about these women being drained of blood. There'll be no rumors, no reports in the paper. The official opinion at this time is that the cause of death is undetermined. We don't want to cause a panic. It's bad for police operations. It's bad for the people. And it's bad for business. Thank you for your cooperation. Kolchak, I want to have a talk with you. Now, boys, there's no reason to bother the doctor anymore. I have a prepared statement in my office. You can go back to the lab. Kolchak, you're becoming a real pest. I'll have to have a word or two with Vincenzo about you. Now, maybe one of the other boys at the office should handle this from here on. Keep your nose clean, son. Stay out of other people's business. It's healthier that way.
Carl, will you watch what you're saying? You know these guys. You could find yourself out of a job in 86 all over town.
That go for you too, Jenks.
Oh, boy, who can talk to you when you get like this? Now, listen, I'll nose around unofficially for you on anything you bring me, just between the two of us. But do me a favor and stay away from me for a few days, just for friendship's sake.
Did I say it was a vampire?
Well, what does your suggested headline say?
The story makes it clear.
Vampire killer in Las Vegas, question mark. Do I misread?
The story makes it clear.
Do I misread, or did you use the word vampire?
Some screwball who imagines he's a vampire is loose in Las Vegas, and people ought to be told.
If there's a screwball running around loose in Las Vegas, his last name begins with a K. You already heard about the little scene you have with the boys downtown. No vampire stories. Clear? How
How about a special featurette with a border of roses? An interview with the two girl victims in heaven with a celestial choir in the background.
I guess I fell asleep.
Yeah.
What were you saying?
You know, you do great things for my masculine ego, you know?
Yes.
Well, actually, I was saying that I think that Vincenzo has a new sense of a tree stump. It's got to be one man. It's got to be big, strong, psychotic.
Well, you're certainly making me very glad that I work nights.
Mm. Oh, well, I told you to quit working nights, didn't you? Kolchak. I am forever in your debt, love.
What was that?
The killer's done it again. Only this time, he was seen. Tall, 125 luscious pounds. Less the weight of 12 pints of blood, of course.
Well, looks like Bella Lugosi's struck again.
Knock it off. It's her daughter.
Oops.
I'm all right now.
Now, the car he drove away in, was it new?
No. It was a few years old, I think. It was maroon coupe.
I'll call it in.
Barney, may I,
Yeah, but, take it easy.
I'm sorry, ma'am. Kolchak, the Daily News. That was your daughter?
My best contact in Las Vegas has always been Helen O'Brien, chief switchboard operator at the county courthouse.
Hello, adorable.
You're a sadist.
Mm-hmm. Well, I could take a bath.
Over my dead, plump body.
Listen, you magnificent morsel. The DMV is checking on the suspect's car. Now, you couldn't help me in that area, could you?
Of course not. Bribed again.
Kolchak. Joe, Brady.
What? How'd you like to see the killer's face?
Thank you.
Miami furniture stores are the most exciting furniture showroom stores in America. The most exciting. You can have this excitement day after day, night after night, year after year, when you come home to RB Furniture.
At C&R, suits designed and priced for the graduate, $79.90 and $89.90, save to $30. Cotton blend denim in the new updated model with pleated pants and action back, just $89.90. Another excellent choice for young men, gabardine with a smooth look and feel of silk, just $79.90. Sizes 35 to 46, a full selection of handsomely styled suits just right for the graduate. Come to C&R and save to $30.
If you pay bills with a checking account, you can get lots of bother and no interest. But now you can phone in your bills with Allstate Savings' new bill call system and get 5% interest on the unused balance in your account. You also get a lot more time on your hands. The bill call system. Come in for details and a demonstration.
This is the time to get a new spring coat for your house.
JCPenney's having a paint and wallpaper sale with incredible savings on our famous one and only exterior paint and on our one and only interior paint. You'll also find ceiling paint, floor and patio paint, and a super selection of our best-selling wallpapers, all at incredible savings.
So go to JCPenney for a new spring coat. Your house deserves it.
This is JCPenney.
And now a Channel 7 editorial.
Recently, a Channel 7 editorial questioned the efficiency of the Hamilton Test Systems program for checking pollution controls on resold automobiles. One of our eyewitness newsmen, Russ Nichols, had his 74 Ford officially certified as meeting state pollution requirements after disconnecting smog control devices. In a rebuttal, Ken Hamilton, who is president of the Independent Garage Owners Association, and to the best of our knowledge, has no connection with Hamilton Test Systems, discounted the test. It wasn't legitimate, he charged, because Russ had broken the law by disconnecting the pollution controls. That totally overlooks the obvious. The car passed the test without the equipment. That being the case, then one must question why Californians are required by state law to buy devices for their cars that don't even show up on pollution checks, but that do increase gas consumption by about 10%. Either that regulation or the test is faulty. As evidence that reporter Nichols' car passing the test was no fluke, Channel 7 has since put another car through the same test with the same devices disconnected. This is the official Hamilton certificate showing that it also met and passed the state pollution standards. I'm Gene Webster. We'd appreciate your comments.
Kolchak.
Shelley Forbes has got to be his fifth victim. Look at the way her dog was killed.
You'll never give up, do you?
What do you mean?
I mean, this is unacceptable.
Unacceptable?
Kolchak, I'm very close to firing you. Even though the owner of this paper has a soft spot in his head for has-been big city reporters. I am tired of your pressure, Kolchak. I'm tired of the owner's pressure. I'm tired of the pressure from all around me to blow the story up on the one hand and keep it under wraps on the other. I am tired of being the middleman, Kolchak. Do you understand that? Can you understand that?
What do you want, Vincenzo? A testimonial from Count Dracula?
Out! Get out!
What is this out-out, gal, get-out game we play? This nut thinks he is a vampire. He has killed four, maybe five women. He has drained every drop of blood from every one of them. Now, that is news, Vincenzo. News! And we are a news paper. We are supposed to print news, not suppress it.
You know darn well why we're soft-pressing this thing.
No! Tell me why. Could it be because we have been told to?
Kolchak, you are an idiot. Worse, you're irresponsible. All these murders mean to you is a byline.
Well, what the hell difference does it matter what it means to me? The point is that we are suppressing news. We are withholding information. Everybody in town knows what's going on. The police, the DA, the coroner's office, every reporter on every newspaper in Las Vegas knows what's going on. The only people who don't know are the people.
At last, you got the point, Kolchak. The people in Las Vegas don't know. Because the people in Las Vegas would come unglued if they did know. Even more than they're coming unglued already. Capish?
Do
Tuesday, May 25th, 7:30 p.m. Helen O'Brien had told me that the DMV had come up with 16 possibles. All but one had been eliminated. The car owner's name, Martin Lubin. Address on Spring Mountain Road. Name and address, both phony. Name of salesman who sold car, Fred Hurley.
So I sets him a price. He don't say nothing. He just stands there looking at me.
All right, now how'd you find out about this, Kolchak?
Well, my little bird told me about it.
Now you just
my account.
Keep your mouth shut.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Well, like I said, he just stands there looking at me. Then he tells me the price is too high. $300 too high. And he keeps staring at me as if daring me to tell him the price is $1,200.
Hey, this fella.
Now stop doing our job for us, Kolchak. That's already been established.
Yeah, well, you see, I told him only he had a mustache.
Mustache? Yeah. Did you sell him the car?
Well, I started to say no. But something inside tells me, don't mess with this guy. I mean, he's a creep. With them red eyes and that voice, he's enough to keep a guy from working nights.
All my life, I've waited for a story like this. All my life. When it finally comes, I can't get it printed. Do you know, the holes in Mary Brandon's neck were airbrushed out before they printed the photographs? Yeah.
Carl, if you keep going on like this, you're going to get fired again. Let's see, how many times has it been? Twice in Washington, three times in New York, twice in Chicago, and once, or was it twice in Boston?
I'm becoming extinct in my own lifetime. Homo nuzlocus, natural habitat, a pool of sour mash bourbon. You know, I really ought to light a candle to Ben Hecht.
Here.
You ought to quit your job, you know.
And you'll support me?
Well, I... Oh, come on, honey, I'm serious. That weirdo said five girls, and they were all night workers.
Five?
Yeah, five.
Oh.
Yeah, a girl named Shelley Forbes is missing, and I'll bet my bottom dollar she's victim number five. Hey, you know, you are insured pretty good there.
Carl, I've been doing some thinking. Oh, what do you know about vampires?
Well, only they wear dinner suits and talk with marbles in their mouth.
Oh, will you please be serious?
Watch my natural habitat, then.
Open it.
Oh. Everything you always want to know about vampires, we're afraid to ask.
No, you're going to look at it.
And why?
Well, what if the killer's a real vampire?
Oh, honey, please. I've had a very
long done everything
week.
That's in this book.
Whoopee, whoopee.
You're going to read it.
Yes, all right. I'm going to read it. Ooh. Ah.
Oh, now, come on. You're a big, tough reporter. You can take it. You might even get a good feature article out of it.
Since the beginning of man's existence, there have been creatures of the night, crazed monsters that track the bloody prints through the pages of fact and fiction. Of them all, the vampire seems to have accumulated the largest body of documentation. By night, the vampire is virtually indestructible, fearing only the sign of the cross. Before daybreak, he must return to his coffin, otherwise he will be destroyed by the purifying rays of the sun. It is then, while he lies dormant, he can be destroyed by hammering a wooden stake through his heart. According to the legend, the victim of the vampire will ultimately rise again as the living dead and must be destroyed in a similar manner. From any source available, the vampire must have blood.
Help! Help! Someone help!
phone APCO Financial Services to borrow money, you're going to be impressed.
Because APCO is me.
We smile at that phone before we pick it up.
Because APCO is me.
We answer our phones on the very first ring.
9,000 people give you their guarantee.
Scout's honor. First ring.
Our people put you in the best company. Because APCO.
Maybe the second. Good morning,
Apple. Okay, America, we challenge you. We challenge you to wear out Tom McCann's incredible Ultrasol and Heal. We bet you can't. In fact, Tom McCann guarantees it. If Ultrasols ever wear out, just bring them in and get your money back. Or a new pair of shoes. Come on, America, try to wear out the Ultrasol. We bet you can't. Ultrasol, on great leather styles, only by Tom McCann. Come on, America, try to wear out the Ultrasol. We bet you can't.
Wherever you go, switch to Sweet AM.
Slender and Trey,
switch to Sweet AM.
The light up your day,
switch to Sweet AM.
And people who know,
switch to Sweet AM.
Have made the switch to Sweet AM.
Put less sugar in your life. Get more out of living. Switch to Sweet AM.
I switch from sugar to Sweet and Low because I care.
It's so... Excuse me. This is a salad check. This three-bean salad versus Reed three-bean salad. Reed three-bean salad is crispy, crunchy, and ready when you are.
Delicious.
It's better than ours.
What a nice change from lettuce salads.
You can depend on Reed's freshness because every can of Reed's is sealed fresh. And the flavor is protected by a white liner to stay fresh. Reed salads, the fresher than deli salads.
I was doing double duty as night editor when the PD squad box went crazy about a wild brawl at the Old Town Hospital. May 27th, 8:20 a.m., and things were rolling. Our morning edition hit the streets recapping all the action at the hospital. The TV people, as usual, had missed out completely, and the radio stations were literally reading our copy on the air. But now the whole lid was really blown off. The maniac had been identified.
Sorry, I'm late. I just got these out of the suit. Yeah.
Now, here's a rundown on the Scotland Yard and the Interpol findings. Subject, Janos Skorzeny. Born in Craiesti, Romania, 1899.
Now, wait just a minute. You trying to tell me this guy's over 70 years old? Come on, Bernie, your boys have come up with the wrong man.
Like hell we have. These facts have been triple-checked and confirmed. Now, look, I've been up all night and I'm pretty tired. Now, do you want it or don't you?
All right, Bernie, just take it easy. Let's hear it.
All right. Skorzeny's father died in 1923. He left somewhere between $75 and $100 million. At this time, he began to travel, and he became known throughout Eastern Europe as a big lover of nightlife. Now, we don't have a lot more on him before World War II. However, Scotland Yard reports that he showed up in England just in time for the German Blitz. I'm sure Mr. Kolchak will find the following facts of interest.
Such formality from a man who always guzzles my beer.
While in England, he passed himself off as Dr. Paul Belasco, specialist in hematology research. His work involved freshly killed air raid victims from various London emergency rooms. As a matter of fact, at his residence in Shaftoe Court, he installed several kinds of sumps, tubs, and an extremely large commercial meat freezer. In 1948, he turned up in Canada still as Dr. Belasco. And further checking made his presence known in almost every place along the U.S.-Canadian border where rioting and violence and a number of dead bodies were found. We believe he left Canada for Vegas April 19th under the name of Detective Constable Alan Hensley. Now, because of his British citizenship, he is an international fugitive. So my people are very interested in him. This is no longer just a local matter. Now, gentlemen, the one constant that has shown up in all of our reports is that Skorzeny's travels have always been accompanied by a number of unexplained killings, many of which have one thing in common. A massive loss of blood. So, if Skorzeny is not the vampire of Mr. Kolchak's theories, he is certainly the suspect of multiple homicides extending back some 30 years.
Mr. Jenks, you seem to be running this show. Could I have meant to say something?
Mr. Kolchak, you have the
floor. Kolchak, you keep it short.
I was at the hospital yesterday, and a lot of things were happening that you just simply cannot explain away. Sheriff, your own men shot at him, some at point-blank range. How come they didn't even slow him down? How come a man over 70 years old can outrun a police car? How come the same man, when slugged in the head, doesn't even bleed? Now, I saw those gashes in his head, and whatever was trickling down from those wounds, it was clear.
This guy's got a motor mouth. Can't we shut him up? No, let him hang himself. Then we'll finally be rid of him.
So far, he has killed four, probably five women. Now, the coroner said that those bite marks on the throat were made by human teeth. He practically confirmed the fact that he actually drank their blood. Now, wait. Whatever the Skorzeny may be, he seemed to be functioning as if he were a vampire. Now, you can go on operating as if he were an ordinary man. That's up to you. But I know that the only way you're going to get him is if you proceed under the assumption that he's a real-life vampire.
Wait a minute, Kolchak, have you lost your mind? Can you imagine the total blind panic this town would be in if the public were told we were actually looking for a vampire? Not to mention the irreparable damage it would do to the image of law enforcement in Vegas.
That's what it's all about, isn't it? That's it. Boy, I really can't believe that you guys are so afraid of appearing stupid that you'll ignore the only possible way of nailing him.
You listen, Kolchak, and you listen good. We'll handle this by ourselves and without undue public observation.
No undue public observation. You've blown it already. Look here. Look what's appeared in my paper today. People are going to be calling for a grand jury investigation. You can't stop the rumors from all over.
Sit down. I don't care what's been printed in the newspapers. This man is still classified as an ordinary maniac, and he'll be settled by standard police procedures.
Oh, boy.
And you better start cooperating with that fact, Kolchak, or you're going to get your pushy-tushy kicked right out of town. You dig?
Yes, I dig. But just remember, the next time you blow it, who's got the answers? Sir?
All right, Ed. Let's get on with it. What have you got?
Well, two departments combined of 650 men on full-time duty. All leaves are canceled, and everyone's working a 16-hour day. Our chopper is going from dusk to dawn. We've got unmarked cars patrolling the casino center and the strip. All roads are blocked, and we're receiving complete cooperation from the highway patrol and the Jeep posse.
You got it?
Got it. Repeat.
What did I say?
Show every real estate agent in town a picture of this guy's puss and ask him if they sold a house to anybody that looks like him.
Good boy, you got it. Now you go.
Now, wait a minute. When'll I lose this last dollar?
Mickey, has the idea of winning ever occurred to you?
You know, I have a very strange, unhappy feeling that the police are never going to catch his murderer. I also have another very unhappy feeling.
Which is?
That this case may be even bigger than I thought it was.
Bigger?
Well, a stranger, then. I've seen a lot of weird things in my life, love. I have never, ever seen anything like this.
You don't tell me that you're finally going to believe?
I don't even want to think about it.
Janos Skorzeny, spotted in 1969. Green unpaneled station wagon. Intersection OK and Hustles. ID confirmed. Positive visual contact made. Units 7 and 8, seal off. Expert and Hustles at OK. Repeat, units 7 and 8. Unit 3, close off.
That's sure to please. It's broccoli, cauliflower, corn, carrots, and peas.
That's really new.
It's new broccoli cauliflower medley, a unique combination of broccoli, cauliflower, and other good vegetables in a sauce so light you can taste each individual vegetable. Broccoli cauliflower medley, a new harvest get-together combination.
Yahoo!
Ho, ho, ho.
Green Giant.
Taste a wrangler, ma'am?
Why taste that? It's just a hot dog.
If you taste it, you'll know it's not a hot dog. It's a Hormel Wrangler.
Now, ma'am, I know a hot dog when I see one.
Wranglers are bigger, coarser ground, more meaty tasting. Just taste it.
No, I still see
because
that.
Because you haven't tasted it. Wranglers have a bigger, smokier taste.
Ooh-wee! No hot dog ever tasted like that.
Taste a Hormel Wrangler. Just taste a Wrangler. And you'll never go back to hot dogs.
Taste a Wrangler, ma'am.
Yeah.
Come to a Kobe shoe store. You'll get fashion for less. Who could ask for more? Kobe shoes.
A mysterious journey.
Is this some kind of joke?
To a faraway land that might not exist.
There is no place like this.
For some, there is fear.
Why doesn't somebody do something?
For others, panic.
SOS! This is an SOS call! We need help!
But few can face the horrible truth.
Every one of us in this room is dead already.
Haunts of the very rich. Ah! Tuesday's 3:30 movie on Channel 7.
and beach. Pure cane sugar from Hawaii.
Sweet Hawaii.
Growing in the sun. When you cook, when you bake, for goodness sake, get CNH. Pure cane sugar, CNH. Pure cane sugar, CNH. Pure cane sugar, that's the one.
Years ago, people eased the pain of migraine headaches with ice.
Today, there's a new natural way to help relieve migraine pain. Temp-Aid Instant Cold Packs. Stored at room temperature. Activated by a squeeze. Temp-Aid Instant Cold Packs. Safe cold for migraines. Temp-Aid Instant Cold Packs for first aid. Temp-Aid Instant Cold Packs. Nicer than ice.
Temp-Aid Instant Cold Packs. Available at all Long's drugstores.
Now through Saturday, get 13 color portraits in a variety of sizes for only $8.95 at any of these Sears photography studios.
Friday, May 28, 3:17 a.m. Despite the helicopters, the highway patrol, the jeep posse, despite the blocking of every major road and highway, despite the mass coverage of Las Vegas by every available man in both police and sheriff departments, Janos Skorzeny was still at large. The courthouse conference room has been a scene of chaos for more than 3 hours now. Messages were still flooding in from every outside unit. Every available man who had taken place in the capture attempt was being debriefed. At the hospital, two officers had died and the third was hovering on the edge. Reports on them were still coming in as the greatest manhunt in the history of Las Vegas continued in vain.
Oh, thanks, Bernie. Yeah. Well, what are we going to do?
Now, are you willing to listen to my insane ideas?
Kolchak,
get out of here.
Warren, hold it, hold it. Kolchak, you were there, weren't you?
Yeah.
Every man we've questioned insists not only that Skorzeny was possessed of incredible strength, but that he was shot more than once during the capture attempt.
Oh, I'd say 30, 40 times.
I'm sorry, I'm not buying that.
Captain, you have two choices. Either he was shot, or your entire police department is blind.
Ed, let's admit it. We had the man, had him cornered, and we couldn't hold him. Let Kolchak have his say.
Oh, before I do, is it agreed that in return for my help, you will grant me the exclusive rights to the entire story?
Well, let's say it's agreeable if we decide to follow your suggestions regarding the suspect.
Fine, fine, because if you don't follow my suggestions, you're going to be chasing your suspect till doomsday.
Kolchak, just get on with it.
Of course. Each man in the field is to be issued one of these. To be carried in his pocket. This gentleman.
Where'd you get that?
Well, I have a friend who's got a furniture repair store. I woke him up and had him make it. Each man of the field has issued one of these and one of these.
Are you suggesting that we pound one of these into Skorzeny's chest?
No, no, into his heart.
There's a legal phrase for that, Kolchak. You might have run into it once or twice in your broad experience. It's called premeditated murder.
The only way you're going to stop him. You heard your own men. Can they all be wrong? Oh, well, you can stop your nighttime chases from now on, too, gentlemen. The only hope you have is to spot Skorzeny and then track him back to where he lives and wait until sunrise before finishing him off. He's only vulnerable during the day. At night, he's much too strong. Yes, gentlemen. I hate to say this, but it looks as if we have a real live vampire on our hands.
Warren.
Yeah.
Tom, I'd like to be in on this, too.
Okay, Kolchak, you got yourself a deal. Conditional.
What's that?
Butcher here will issue the crosses, the mallets, the stakes. The one thing he won't do is depart from established police procedures. If feasible, Skorzeny is to be taken alive and held for trial.
Trial?
That's right, trial. Trial.
All right. In return for what?
You'll get the exclusive rights of the story.
Good.
When the blackout is lifted.
Any other conditions?
One more.
What's that?
If it turns out you're wrong, you're to be out of town in 12 hours. Take it or leave it.
All right, I'll take it. Because I know I'm right. And you know I'm right. Right. Ciao!
I'll take Manhattan, the Bronx and Staten Island, too.
Watch out, you great big wonderful Big Apple. Kolchak's coming back.
As Manhattan's coming here, with a lip to a man. She's hot, that I'm, she's hot.
Driving off with me in the back seat.
What are you doing in my back seat?
I wanted to talk to you. I saw your car parked here, so I got in to wait for you, and I got sleepy.
You got sleepy.
Hey.
I think I found the house.
Yes, I once served a muffin other than a Thomas's to the bishop. Praise be, he's a forgiven man.
Yes, tried something besides Thomas's once. Cost less.
Yep. Tasted like it, too.
Other muffins just don't compare to Thomas's because Thomas's have all those nooks and crannies to make them crisp and crunchy outside, yet light and airy inside.
Yeah, as a matter of fact, I just gave the general one of those other muffins.
Nothing tastes better than a Thomas's. Thomas's promises.
With sunscreen lotions, sun-sensitive people can get out in the sun. But in the water, their sunscreens can wash off.
Oops, you lost your sunscreen.
So they can get sunburned. That's why Johnson & Johnson developed Sundown, the non-greasy protective sunscreen lotion that stays on, even when you're in and out of the water. So don't get burned just because you want to get wet.
Sundown.
In extra and moderate protection lotions.
We've created something brand new at Taco Bell, and we're all really excited about it. We call it the Taco Supreme, and you're gonna love it. It's our own famous taco, made special with fresh, ripe tomatoes and real sour cream. Doesn't it look delicious? Wait till you taste it. The Taco Supreme. Come on in and let me make one for you. I made this one for me. The Taco Supreme. Brand new and only at Taco Bell. Come try one.
You want to lighten up? Here's a beautiful new way for you to get rid of a little extra weight. Tab, in the new 2-liter lightweight plastic bottle. It gives you 5% more than a half gallon, but still only one little calorie in every delicious serving, plus all that same great cola taste. So lighten up with Tab in the new 2-liter lightweight plastic bottle. It's a lot less weight to carry around.
Jerry Dunphy here tonight at 5. Ann Martin begins an in-depth study of our criminal justice system and why convicted rapists are often set free and rape again. The lines today were a little bit shorter, and police begin a crackdown on gas stations that violate the odd-even rules. The school board looks for ways to save gasoline, and Al Julius, he wonders what can be done about the gas crunch. Orange County authorities issue warnings about floating bombs, and Dr. Art Yaleen says those plants around your house could kill you. That and more tonight at 5, when Harold Green joins me right here for Eyewitness News on Channel 7. We'll all be here. We'll see you then.
I told Clark to give me 30 minutes before telling Jenks where I was. That way I could get to see the house alone for a while and also keep the police from arriving before dawn, which I knew they'd do if they got the chance, no matter what I told them.
Could one man be as romantic as Robert Redford, as devilish as Burt Reynolds, as tough as Clint Eastwood?
The king is not averse to affairs.
And as sexy as John Travolta. He couldn't, unless there were two of him. It's Peter Sellers and Peter Sellers in The Prisoner of Zenda, rated PG.
Starts Friday at Band's Chinese Hollywood and other selected theaters in Los Angeles and Orange Counties.
When you've got a headache, what does extra strength mean to you?
It means a crummy headache won't ruin your day. It means Excedrin.
Extra strength means relief is in sight. Extra strength means Excedrin.
Extra strength means not feeling the pain anymore. Extra strength means Excedrin.
Excedrin, the extra strength pain reliever. More total strength than any regular strength aspirin or non-aspirin tablet. Excedrin. For millions of people.
Extra strength means Excedrin.
Experience two nights of musical history at San Diego Stadium, Friday, June 8th and Saturday, June 9th, 8 p.m. The fifth annual San Diego Cool Jazz Festival, starring Teddy Pendergrass, Marvin Gaye, Natalie Cole, The Emotions, Chic, The Barquets, Rose Royce, Rick James, Tamares, and B.B. King. Tickets are on sale now at all Ticketron outlets for the fifth annual San Diego Cool Jazz Festival, Friday and Saturday, June 8th and 9th, San Diego Stadium. Be there.
Give me a smile with everything on it. I'll pass it on. Give me a Coke when you smile, and I promise to pass it along. I'm gonna pass it along. The world needs a lift when it's tired and thirsty. Coke and a smile is how it should be. Coke adds life. Coca-Cola adds life.
Shakespeare's bewitching tale, The Tempest, takes you to an island of magic, music, and mystery found only at the Mark Taper Forum of the Music Center. Come along now.
Thank you.
We're on? Okay, we're back. Look, I don't care what you say, everything ages.
But Armor All Protected helps slow down that aging.
But how does it work?
Look inside that car. The dashboard, seats, door panels. One half is faded with age.
Well, it looks old, so.
We sprayed the other half with Armor All Protectant. See? The color's back. It feels soft, looks fresh, doesn't look its age.
Gee, that's how I'd like to look.
That might take another scientific achievement.
We'll be back.
You can get Armor All Protectant at your favorite automotive or drugstore.
Great green capes! Look up there!
Who is that?
It's Color Tile Man, and he's headed for Color Tile!
Yikes! It's another Color Tile breakthrough!
Egads! Hurry to Color Tile now for wall-busting low prices on ceramic tile with lustrous glaze from only 69 cents per square foot. Or choose our Solar Shine no-wax floor tile from only 69 cents. At Color Tile, you always find a huge in-stock selection of tile, paint, and wallpaper.
Shop Color Tile!
Why do women who try Hormel Cure 81 hams keep buying them year after year? Listen.
In the nearly 5 years that I've been buying the Cure 81 ham, I've never been disappointed. That's dependability, worth paying for.
You know, in 12 years, we've never been disappointed in a Cure 81 ham. Now that's dependability, worth paying for.
Dependability. That's what you get with Hormel Cure 81 ham.
Welcome to a sparkling world of refreshment.
Aspen is here, crisp and crystal clear.
Aspen, the soft drink with just a snap, a tantalizing snap of apple.
Discover Aspen.
The soft drink with just a snap of apple.
Discover Aspen.
Hello, I'm Theodore Bickel. This year, we are dedicating ourselves to Jewish renewal at home and overseas, extended by all of us who care deeply for human life.
Do you think they'll print it?
I don't know, they will. We've got an agreement.
Hey, you look kind of tired. Do you want me to drive you to the office?
Go on, Hushabye. Hushabye.
Yeah.
But I want to finish this in time for the special kitchen. Why don't you stop working nights?
Oh, Carl, not that again.
And marry me?
What?
Well, you're a good cooker and a good kisser. Why not?
Oh, baby, you're gonna love New York City. Honey, after this story hits the news services with my byline...
Oh, well, us married?
Yes, us married! Don't look now, baby. But Kolchak's coming back in style.
There you are, Vincenzo. And if I do say so myself, it's sensational.
I'm sure it is, Carl.
You're going to put in the special edition.
Right.
Yeah, with pictures.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, and the news services.
Okay, fine.
What's got into you, Vincenzo? Are you sick or something?
Nothing. This is all fine, Carl. Fine. Jenks has been trying to reach you.
Yeah, what do you want?
You want to see over at the DA's office. Why don't you run over there now?
Yeah.
Phone Jack. You're one hell of a reporter.
Thank you, sir. And a bright good morning to all of you. Bernie, what did you,
Is your name Carl Kolchak, and do you reside in the city of Las Vegas?
Well, you know my name's Carl Kolchak. What's going on?
Carl Kolchak, you're under arrest on the charge of murder. The state requires that you be informed that you have the right to remain silent.
No. Oh, no. No chance. You're not going to pull that one on me. No.
Kolchak! You are under arrest.
All right, Payne, just what kind of a dirty deal is this?
You have a very short memory, Kolchak. A few hours ago, Sheriff Butcher himself saw you actually pound a wooden stake through a man's heart with this mallet. A man wanted for questioning. Questioning, mind you. He hadn't been arrested. He hadn't even been charged.
You broke up our stakeout. And after we were kind enough to invite you to go along, you just charged in there in front of us and killed Janos Skorzeny before we had a chance to do anything. Well, you were even ranting and raving about this Skorzeny being some kind of a vampire, and you had to save the world.
And that, Mr. Kolchak, is murder one. Now, if you plead insanity, you might get lucky, but I promise you this. You'll be committed to an asylum for the rest of your life.
I pull your fat out of the fire and you do this.
Carl, will you just sit down a minute and listen to them?
Bernie, you were there!
Carl, just listen.
This is your story, Kolchak. It's already being printed. This morning, shortly before sunrise, Las Vegas sheriff deputies under the command of Sheriff Warren A. Butcher, 45, surrounded the home of Janos Skorzeny, a fugitive from a federal warrant, and in a pitch gun battle, were forced to kill him.
Never. You'll never get away with it.
What's to stop me?
You're gonna stop yourself, Kolchak. Because if you open your mouth, we'll find you, bring you back, use this warrant, and put you away forever. Pick him up, Kolchak. Pick him up and get out of town. Now, we'll take care of your back rent.
I want to call Gail.
She's not there, Carl.
What have you done with her?
Nothing. We just asked the young lady if she'd be good enough to leave town.
She's an undesirable element, Kolchak, and we don't want undesirable elements in Las Vegas.
Carl, there's nothing I can do. Carl, you let me know where you end up, huh?
Yeah, sure, Bernie. I'll keep in touch.
Ends have been gathered together and tied into a pretty knot right around the neck of guess who. After I left town, I began putting notices in the personal columns of newspapers from San Francisco to St. Louis. Until I ran out of money, that is. So far, I've received no answers, but I'll keep trying, even though I don't think I'll ever find Gail Foster again. Maybe it's just as well. So that's it. The book's finished. And now you'll have to judge for yourself. I must warn you, however, if you try to verify this account, you will find it quite impossible. Item, in Washington, D.C., there was no longer a file listing the suspect under his true name or any of his alleged aliases. Item, in Las Vegas, all of those who were involved have either left town, aren't talking, or are dead. I haven't had a decent night's sleep since all this happened. And now you might find it difficult, too. Because there is still one fact that cannot be buried. After the death of Janos Skorzeny, he and all of his victims were immediately cremated. Why? Remember the legend? All those who die from the bite of the vampire will return as a vampire, unless destroyed first. So think about it and try to tell yourself, wherever you may be, in the quiet of your home, in the safety of your bed, try to tell yourself, it couldn't happen here.
Style yogurt with nothing artificial. Real fruit in creamy, smooth yogurt. How's it taste?
Fresh and fruity.
At Vons, we're as concerned about prices these days as you are. And we're interested in hearing what our customers have to say.
I found Vons prices are competitive, or usually a few cents lower.
I buy everything there, even tennis shoes.
The double the difference offer means that Vons is really sincere about keeping prices lower.
These comments are important to us, because at Vons, we're still working hard to keep our prices low. Come see for yourself.
I really believe Vons' prices are right.
Meet George Michaels, Mexican food lover. He doesn't know it, but he's about to discover pizzazz.
New El Chico Mexican-style pizza, made with all the things that make Mexican food exciting, like spicy chili and taco-seasoned beef, tangy cheddar and Monterey Jack cheese, and a thick flour tortilla. New El Chico Mexican-style pizza. It's got pizzazz.
Mazola has something that no other leading oil has. That's because Mazola's the only one that's made from corn. Not sunflowers, not soybeans, but corn. Mazola corn oil is 100% corn oil and nothing else. Look, you know Mazola's low in saturated fat. You know it has no cholesterol. You know no oil tastes lighter than Mazola. But in case you didn't know where all that goodness comes from, here's your answer. Golden American corn.
Cloris Leachman is upset. Tomorrow at 3:30.
Police plan a crackdown on gas stations that violate the odd-even rules. And odd-numbered drivers found lines a little shorter today.
The lieutenant governor tells Eyewitness News he's ready to call a special election on forced busing. And tonight, Ann Martin begins a series of reports on convicted rapists who are set free, often to rape again.
Also tonight, vandals hit some area gas stations. Someone's trying to set off bombs in Orange County. Al Julius wonders what we can do about the gas crunch. Dr. Art Yulin has a warning about plants. Ed Arnold with sports, and Dr. George says the clouds are going to be around for a while. Next on Eyewitness News.
Champale, the ultimate experience. Tastes something like champagne without the high price tag. Champale, sparkling malt liquor from Iroquois Brand.
Introducing PSA Smile Service to Las Vegas with the lowest airfare to Las Vegas on every seat of every plane beginning May 23rd.
You must watch tonight at 7:30.